Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to edit grid records by using different cell editing types and modes in ViewGrid. I will also show you how to add custom editor components to grid columns using templates. I will open my existing view application where a simple grid code is added and the local JSON data is assigned to the grid data source property, which you must be already familiar with if you have watched my previous video. Those who have not seen it yet can find that video link from the description section below or the card shown above. You can also get the downloadable sample link from the description part. First, let's see the different kinds of editing modes available in ViewGrid one by one. To start working with the editing modes, import the edit module from the Syncfusion EJ2 ViewGrids package. And to show the editing options on a grid toolbar, I need to import the toolbar module as well. Now add these modules in the grid array inside the provide object under the script section. The next mandatory option to perform an edit operation on a data grid is to specify the primary key column on the view grid by enabling isPrimaryKey property in orderID column. And then under the script section, define the edit options variable and enable options like allow adding, allow editing, and allow deleting properties. Here, I will define the edit mode as normal. Then, I will assign this edit options variable to the edit settings property of the grid. Next, I will define a toolbar options variable and assign the array of items like add, edit, delete, update, and cancel. Then, I will assign this variable to the toolbar property of the grid. Now, I will run this example and show you the output on the browser. As you can see, the ViewGrid shows the edit options on the toolbar. I can also start editing a record by double-clicking it or by selecting a specific row and then clicking on the edit option from the toolbar. Usually, when I double-click a grid row to edit its value, text boxes are displayed on all the grid columns. But in a real-time application, you may need to customize the text box to display different editor components on each grid column. You can use any of these 6 built-in cell edit types to customize the text box in ViewGrid. Here in this example, I'm going to display numeric editor for the freight column by defining the edit type as numeric edit under the eColumns directive. And then I'm going to display a drop-down list editor for the customer ID field by defining its edit type as drop-down edit. I will show you the output on the browser. Now, when I double-click on a grid row, you can see the editor columns like drop-down and numeric components displayed on the corresponding grid columns. I can also customize these components by setting their properties using the edit option. Next, I will show you how to apply the format for the value displayed on the numeric text box. Inside the data method of script section, I will declare the numeric params variable of object type and define the format property and set its value as C2. I will assign this variable to the edit option of the freight column. Now, when I double click the records, you can see the freight value is displayed in the currency format. Apart from the built-in edit types, you can also display custom components on the grid columns using edit template option. Now I will show you an example of how to display masked text box on a specific grid column. First, I'm going to bind an additional column, ship postal code, to the grid from the data source. Then to show masked text box while editing this column, I need to install the EJ2 View Inputs package from Syncfusion. Once the package is installed, import the Masked Textbox plugin from the EJ2 View Inputs package. Here, to start using Masked Textbox in my application, I am defining it inside the View.use method. Under the Methods object of script section, I will define the EditTemplate method and return the Masked Textbox plugin from it. Now, I will include ID property and bind it to the shippostal code field from the grid. Then I will include VFN model directive to bind data to the masker text box by accessing shippostal codes field from the grid data source. I will also include the mask property with appropriate format. Then I will assign this method to the edit template property of the corresponding column directive. To use the template option in view components, enable the runtime compiler in view.config.js file. I will run my application now and show you the output. As you can see, when I double click the grid records, the masker text box is shown for the shippostal code column and I can enter only integer values here. Now I will move to the next topic. Let me explain the three editing modes available in the view grid. They are inline, dialog and batch modes. So far, the examples that I have shown you are enabled with inline edit mode, which is the default mode. When you want to edit and save bulk changes to the server in a single request, you can use the batch mode. To perform bulk editing, under the data method in the script section, change the mode property value as batch within the edit settings. Now I can edit multiple records in the grid and save those changes to the server in a single request. You can see editor cells are highlighted and it can be saved using update option in the toolbar. You can also edit the grid record values using built-in dialogs. For that, I should replace the edit mode value as dialog in edit settings. Now I will save this example and show you the output. You can see here, when I double click the grid records, I can edit and save the data using the built-in dialog. Now let me make a quick summary of what we have seen so far. I have shown you how to edit grid records by using the built-in and custom cell editing types. I have also shown you the different editing modes in the view grid. You can also check our user guide documentation link provided in the below description section to learn more about editing in our Syncfusion ViewGrid. Post your comments below if you need additional information about any grid topics. Thank you for watching this video. If you find this video as useful, give a like and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos. Thank you.